Hello, my name's Richard Sandling, and this is my roundup of 2010 in film. Avatar. James Cameron does his bit for the environment by recycling all his old shit into one brand new big old piece of shit. Sex in the City 2. This is like a parody of Sex in the City, written by someone who hates Sex in the City and can't write. It is so appallingly outdated, cliché, hackneyed and offensive in its depictions of men and women, of foreign nationals, of religion, of race, of sex, of relationships, of homosexuals, they may as well have called this film Carry On Slagging. The A-Team. I haven't enjoyed myself that much at the cinema for ages. I giggled like a child all the way through it. It's funny, it's entertaining, it's dramatic, it's action-packed, it's everything you want from an A-Team film. Robin Hood. Ridley Scott and old Grumpy Guts get together to bring us the true accent behind the legend. And it turns out that accent is Thomas the Tank Engine.
I'm gonna rob from the rich, said Robin.
The Expendables. I haven't been this disappointed since Alien vs. Predator. The scene with Stallone, Willis and Schwarzenegger is like a competition to see who can do the worst acting. The script doesn't help, of course. It was clearly felt that with a cast like this, the film would write itself. Unfortunately, that appears to be exactly what's happened. And if anything was written down, I imagine it was written down in crayon. Inception. Poorly written and with no understanding of its own internal logic, Inception is like watching a shit Matrix filmed like a Bourne movie. The special effects aren't, and the ideas aren't really all that original either. For a film that's solely designed to blow your mind, it is incredibly pedestrian and unexceptional. Eat. Pray. Love. Watch. Regret. Leave. Let me in. In The Magnificent Seven, someone had the brilliant idea that transposing the seven samurai to the Old West and making them cowboys instead of samurai would make for a really enjoyable film. Similarly, someone had the brilliant idea that Victorian miser Scrooge might work very well as a modern day TV executive. That's fine. That is filmmakers thinking outside the box, creating remakes where both versions can coexist comfortably in the same universe. This film, however, like so many modern remakes, exists solely to entertain people who are too stupid or lazy to read subtitles. Not so much a rubbish film as a completely pointless one. Down Terrace. Down Terrace is a phenomenal low-budget British crime movie. It's brilliantly written, it's brilliantly directed, everyone in it is fantastic. It's dark, it's tense, it's moody, it's funny. Everything plays out with such a grim inevitability that it keeps you glued to the screen no matter what's happening and makes you think about it for a long time afterwards. I cannot recommend it highly enough. Eclipse. I unintentionally ruined this film for everyone in the cinema because I laughed my ass off all the way through it. I didn't realise it wasn't supposed to be a comedy and that everything that took place was deadly serious. Because believe you me, it's one of the funniest films I've ever seen. I laughed like a drain. It was ridiculous. If I'd have been smoking a cigar, it would have been like Cape Fear. The Film Council. 2010 saw the disbanding of the Film Council by the coalition government. This sent shockwaves throughout the British film community where lots of new and exciting filmmakers were wondering who would now pretend that letting Warner Brothers film Harry Potter at Pinewood meant they were a co-producer on the film. Who now would be paying for the subtitling of Woody Allen's films? And who now, most importantly, wouldn't want to fund anything they submitted? I can't say that I'm really that sad to see the Film Council go. Knowing that they will never fund one of my films is like knowing that as an actor I can never be in the bill. Good riddance, idiots. I've been Richard Sandling. Thanks very much for watching my roundup of some of the films that came out in 2010. Hopefully in 2011, some more films will be released that I might actually like.